Hello everyone, in this video we shall be exploring some concepts, we shall be explaining some concepts. Thanks for tuning in, it's Kisembo Academy. Let's look at the mechanism of electrical conduction. How does electric conduction take place? Let's draw a diagram of a conductor like this. Let's say this is a wire. We all know that a wire has got free moving electrons in it, electrons that are not required for bonding. So if we are to connect a dry cell here across this conductor, then it means that an electric field is going to be set up in this conductor. When an electric field is set up into that conductor, it means that these electrons are going to drift in the direction that is opposite the electric field. As far as this cell is concerned, this is the positive terminal and this is the negative terminal. And we know that the electric field that will be formed in this conductor will be moving in the direction, in that direction, from positive, it will be moving in that direction. So it means that these electrons will be moving in that direction. And when those electrons move in that direction, then they constitute what we call the electric current. So in brief, or in other words, every metal has free moving electrons which are not required for bonding. These are in a state of rapid and random motion and will not have a net flow in any direction. When a battery is connected across the ends of the metal, an electric field is set up in it, and this causes the electrons to gain kinetic energy, to be accelerated in the opposite direction to that of the field. In their movement or flow in this direction, they constitute what we call an electric current, and that is the mechanism of electric conduction. Let's get to the next. Why do metals heat up, or why does a metal heat up when current flows through it? Like we had earlier said, these electrons that are always freely moving in a metal are always, they will drift in a certain direction when the electric field is set up across the ends. So when these electrons are drifting, they'll collide with the atoms in this conductor. This conductor has got an atom. So as these electrons are drifting, they are colliding with these atoms, and these electrons are losing their kinetic energy to the atoms. When they lose their kinetic energy to the atoms, these atoms within this conductor start vibrating. When they start vibrating about their positions, they cause the internal energy of that, the internal energy of the conductor to increase, and that is what is the source of heat. So in other words, we can say collisions between the electrons and atoms here increase. They increase the vibrational energy of the atoms, and therefore they increase the internal energy of the metal. This increases the internal energy of the conductor, therefore increasing the temperature of the conductor. And that basically explains why a metal will heat up when current flows through it. So let's take note also, let's not forget, we shall explain this in another video, that the increase in vibrational energy will create a larger collision area between the electrons and the atoms. And as a result, it will increase the resistance to flow of current in that conductor. We shall explain that more when we look at some of the factors that affect resistance of a conductor. So let's derive this. We have a formula here. Current is going to be equal to A N E V. It's a formula that we shall encounter with later. But let's try and derive it now. Let's assume we are having a conductor like that. It has got a cross-sectional area A. It has a certain length L. And it has got electrons. This is an electron drifting in that direction. That's an electron drifting in that direction. And we have current in amperes drifting in that direction. We all know that current, this current that is flowing, is the rate of flow of charge. So if current is the rate of flow of charge, it means that current I is going to be equal to Q, which is in coulombs, divide that by time. But you know that the charge Q is going to be equal to the number of electrons times the charge on these electrons, E, which is 1.6 times 10 to the power negative 19. Divide that by the time taken for an electron to drift from here to there, time. So we continue that derivation. We know that this becomes N times E, divide that by time. Now we know that distance is going to be equal to speed times time, or velocity times time. So if we make time the subject of the formula, T, it means that T is going to be equal to the distance over speed, or let's call it velocity. So it means that the distance D, in which case the distance here, it is from the between the conductor, so our distance here is L. So it is L over V. So it means this is going to be, NE is going to be equal to L over V. This here, we are looking at the number of electrons is one electron and E. Now here we are considering the electrons in this entire conductor. So it means that we are going to multiply N by the volume of this conductor. So it's going to become the number of electrons times the volume of this conductor, which is cross-sectional area times the length, which is capital A times L, then times the E, divide that by L over V. This will become N A L E V over L. This V, the two L's will cancel out. You remain with your formula for current going to be equal to A N E V. And that's how we derive this formula for current. We derive it like that. And in this case, A stands for the cross-sectional area of the conductor, N stands for the number of electrons in that conductor, E stands for the charge on each of those electrons, which is 1.6 times 10 to the power negative 19. Then V is not volume, V is the velocity, the drift velocity of those electrons. So let's look at the last concept here, current density. What is current density? Current density is the current flowing per unit cross-sectional area of a conductor at right angles to the direction of flow. I'll repeat the definition. It is the current flowing per unit cross-sectional area of a conductor at right angles to the direction of flow. And current density is denoted by J. So from our definition, we know that current density is going to be current, divide that by the cross-sectional area, A. So we know that our current is that. So current is going to be A, N, E, V, divide that by A. When A cancel out, we remain with our current density J as N, E, V. And that is our formula for current density. In our next video, we shall be looking at Ohm's law. Otherwise, this brings us to the end of this video. Thanks for watching. Please remember to like and share this video, and for more videos, please subscribe. Please like our Facebook page at Kisembo Academy Video Tutorials, or follow us on Twitter at Kisembo Academy. For Kisembo Academy, this is Arnold Rangakuramia. Catch you in the next video.